that on purpose, didn't you?
Chief should never be allowed to fly drunk.
We need to get to the bridge. From there, we can use the captain's neural implants to initiate an overload of the ship's fusion engines. The explosion should damage enough systems below it to destroy the ring.
So here we are, the last level. And as you'd expect by now, the polar bottom is infested by the flood. Just because. And Sentinels! An old friend is here eventually. Just stay dead, please. How embarrassing. That's never happened to me. Alright, so the last mission is... it's pretty enjoyable. Not as good as... I'd say Halo 3's is a lot better. Well, actually, now that I think about it, compared to all the rest of the Halos, the last mission for this is actually not that good, but... still pretty fun overall. Commando elites. Not allowed to use fuel rod guns in here. It's dangerous. See? Right. I don't think it's ever actually explained why the... The Covenant sent commandos to the Pillar of Autumn's crash site. Especially now when it's like the ship's a wreck, it can't fly. The flood can't really use it.
I need you to upload me into the control systems. The terminal is located next to the main view screen. I leave home for a few days and look what happens. This won't take long. There. That should give us enough time to make it to a lifeboat and put some distance between ourselves and Halo before the detonation.
I'm afraid that's out of the question, really.
Oh, hell.
Ridiculous! That you would imbue a warship's AI with such a wealth of knowledge? Weren't you worried it might be captured? Or destroyed?
He's in my data arrays, a local tap.
You can't imagine how exciting this is, to have a record of all of our lost time. Human history, is it? Fascinating. Oh, how I will enjoy every moment of its categorization. To think that you would destroy this installation as well as this record. I am shocked. Almost too shocked for words.
He stopped a self-destruct sequence.
Why do you continue to fight us, Reclaimer? You cannot win! Give us the construct, and I will endeavor to make your death relatively painless and...
At least I still have control over the comm channels.
Where is he?
I'm detecting taps throughout the ship. Sentinels, most likely. As for the monitor... he's in engineering. He must be trying to take the core offline. Even if I could get the countdown restarted... I don't know what to do.
How much firepower would you need to crack one of the engine shields?
Not much. A well-placed grenade, perhaps, but why... Okay, I'm coming with you. Chief, Sentinels!
I love the Outer. Kinda wish I had a better role in this game.
The ship was heavily damaged when it crashed. Head to the cryo chamber. We should be able to get to the engine room through there.
Oh, that's a lot of flood. I really don't remember last time we playing this, there was this much fucking flood. At least they're giving me a lot of ammunition. Oh no. Whoa, fuck. It's dangerous to use fuel rod guns indoors. So since this is the last mission, I guess I'll finally explain what I'm actually doing when this is done. When this is done, well, by the time this is uploaded, I'll probably have started my playthrough of Halo 2. When Halo 2 is done, I guess I'll probably do Halo Wars. A game I'd really like to do a series on is Crusader Kings 2. Because it's probably my favourite game right now, but I will admit, as fun as Crusader Kings is to play, it's not really that fun to watch, I guess. No, they'll just, it takes a long time for things to happen, and I guess it just wouldn't be that interesting for people to watch. If people want to, if you want like a CK2 series, just say so and I'll start it. Well, on CK2, I'd probably do a Hearts of Iron. It's basically CK2, but it's basically all war based. It's much more fun to watch. Oh, hello. Come on! Oh no. What's with all the hunters? Eep. I just let the hunters kill him on my shields recharge. There it is there. Huh, where the fuck do I go? I came this way, I think. No, I guess I just like free ammo. Kinda sorry about this, it's just I guess I'm just a bit stupid sometimes. People are probably ripping their dicks off sharing that, man. not that sweet, is it? This way? I really don't want to be backtracking right now. Oh. Let fuse run away.
Engine room located. We're here. Alert! The monitor has disabled all command access. We can't restart the countdown. The only remaining option is to detonate the ship's fusion reactors. That should do enough damage to destroy Halo. Don't worry, I have access to all of the reactor schematics and procedures. I'll walk you through it. First, we need to pull back the exhaust couplings. That will expose a shaft that leads to the primary fusion drive core.
She said shaft. Yes, I am a genius. I'm not even sure that's the proper way to go, I just like to go that, try that way. That was a bad idea. Yeah, you could have probably unloaded about 8 rockets in to get this far if you can't damage them. Wouldn't help if Chief was so goddamn floaty. I'm sure this is like cheaty way. I don't remember climbing up there just to get it a couple of times. Previous playthroughs. I'm fed up with all of these goddamn fucking flood. Nice spark.
Good. Step one complete. We have a straight shot into the fusion reactor. We need a catalyst explosion to destabilize the magnetic containment field surrounding the fusion cells. Use an explosive. I recommend a grenade or rocket. If you run out of explosives, there is an armory station located near the engine room's entrance.
Oh my god. Oh, I am so fucking stupid.
Engine room located. We're here. Alert! The monitor has disabled all command access. We can't restart the countdown. The only remaining option is to detonate the ship's fusion reactors. That should do enough damage to destroy Halo. Don't worry, I have access to all of the reactor schematics and procedures. I'll walk you through it. First, we need to pull back the exhaust couplings. That will expose a shaft that leads to the primary fusion drive core.
Please, surrender the construct, and I will endeavor to make the necessary repairs as quickly as possible.
Come on. How?
Not acceptable, Reclaimer. You must surrender the
good. Step one complete. We have a straight shot into the fusion reactor. We need a catalyst explosion to destabilize the magnetic containment field surrounding the fusion cells. Use an explosive. I recommend a grenade or rocket. If you run out of explosives, there is an armory station located near the engine room's entrance. Analyzing. Fusion reactor number one destabilizing. Use explosive. forces on the other three reactors. That should be enough to trigger a wildcat explosion of the engines.
Sorry, Spark. Oh god. Naked Armor Shields, I always forget how powerful Sentinel Beams fucking are. Right. Die Flood. Almost overshot that to Helga.
Keep it up. Only one more fusion reactor to go.
I think I remember the very first time I ever played this mission. I think I spent about 2 hours on this part because I was like, how do I get up there? I can't get up. But now I finished it in like, what, 10 minutes?
That did it. The engine's gone critical. Based on the current rate of decay, we should have 15 minutes to get off the ship. We don't have much time. We should move outside and signal for evac. Accessing schematics.
Surrender the construct.
There's a service lift at the top of the engine room. It leads to a Class 7 service corridor that runs along the ship's dorsal structure. Hurry!
Now it's time for the fun part. Oh god. Come on, Master Chef. I always wondered how the hell that Pelican actually got there and still has fuel.
When it reaches zero, the engines will detonate. The explosion will generate a temperature of almost 100 million degrees. Don't be here when it blows.
And let's drive, bitches. Mike can't drive. Chief never got his license. This is the home stretch, the end of the game. I mean, I've really enjoyed playing Halo 1 again. It's still legitimately one of my favourite games of all time. Even without the rose-tinted goggles. The story is really good. Even though the graphics are fucking atrocious by today's standards, the gameplay is still pretty good. If a bit slow. It's not as fast as the newer ones. But I can understand that. The game came out in 2001. It was a launch title for the Xbox. Come on, Chief. No room for stopping. I always wondered if it's possible to do that bit just running. Someone's probably done it. Yeah, this bit is, if I ever do Halo 3, I'll probably note that. How Halo 3 is essentially tributed the end of the game by this. By having just a warthog through a blowing up Halo. Pretty good. But Halo 3 did it better because in that the warthogs were actually fast. In this game, all the vehicles are slow. So I literally can't wait to start playing Halo 2 properly again, because it's when the game finally fixed itself, I would say.
Wait, stop! This is where Foehammer is coming to pick us up. Hold position here.
Right.
Cortana to Echo 419. Two Covenant Banshees are approaching on your six. Evade. Say again, evade.
I'm hit. Mayday. Mayday.
Ghostbusters
are trying to help. I can't hold on.
Bye.
Echo 419.
I never explained how that pelican survived for so fucking long.
Calculating alternate escape route.
And didn't refuel.
Ship's inventory shows one longsword fighter is still docked in launch base 7.
They're not fighters, they're bombers.
Now we can make it.
It kinda irks me because I know a lot about the lore, but longswords aren't fighters, Cortana, they're fucking bombers. Pretty cool bombers. Why was so much covenant on this? Up at this stage. Probably gonna need to look into that just for clearing my mind, because it makes no sense.
Up ahead, there's a gap in the trench. At top speed, we should be able to clear it.
Ow, fuck. Oh Christ. Ah, Halo, your music is so goddamn good.
That's the ship. Move, we need to get aboard now.
Run, Chief. You're too slow. Ah, well, what the hell. Well, goodbye, Halo. It's been fun.
else make it?
Scanning. Just dust and echoes. We're all that's left. We did what we had to do. For Earth. An entire Covenant armada obliterated and the Flood. We had no choice. Halo. It's finished.
No. I think we're just getting started.